Our conference can assist you to create a roadmap for your next venture with lessons learned from those who have done it before, and give you a chance to ask questions and learn from experts. Managers and companies which devote resources in these areas will benefit from this informational edge. That's what we try to accomplish here. We will have over 85 exemplary speakers, experts, 22 dynamic panels over the course of 2 days. So this is going to be run by like a TV show. Everything will be on time. Thank you.
Well, this is my first Beryl Elites event, and I think it's an excellent conference to come to a spot in New York where we can discuss alternative data and really technology disruption is a real benefit. Grant Thornton, Puerto Rico, referred to as Kevin Grant Thornton, is a sponsor here, and I'm also here in support of my colleagues. We have Grant Thornton speakers, so I feel like that our brand has been strong here, the networking has been great. I can add that that I think this is a great venue for professionals to come and then to really listen and study and understand how this ecosystem fits together. You know, Grant Thornton is trying to be the firm of the future and helping to shepherd our clients through technology disruption. So I'm not sure if my predictions would be very valuable, but I do find this is a great environment for that understanding.
So what I think of the conference so far, my biggest takeaway from the panel discussions, well, I'm impressed with the quality of the speakers and the amount of knowledge I've gained. I was on a panel yesterday, and I think I learned more as a panelist than most people in the audience, because the people are great. I'm moderating the panel today, and one thing about being a moderator, the rules get out of the way and just tee them off. I'm just learning so much. I think the audience appreciates that, and I just love the high quality. It's one of the unique conferences I've been to where there's a lot of people's suits on. Not that that's good or bad, but it means I think it shows to me there's a high quality. People step it up, they're here, they're behaved. It's all really about the knowledge transfer, and I'm getting a lot of that. I'm loving it. I started in the trading pits in 1988 in Chicago. They no longer exist. I came to New York. I was a voice broker for a while. I was a strategist, a trader. That business is gone. Technology is advancing rapidly. You have to be ahead of it. And to me, that's why this conference is so important. There's a book I'm reading right now called Robot Proof. To me, that's what this conference is about. We have to do that, have to be there. I'm really big in strategizing. I work for Bloomberg with cryptocurrencies and digital assets. And to me, that's just something I have to be involved in because it's the future.
This event, Beryl Elites, it's about artificial intelligence, which is changing the world we live in for the better quality of life on Earth. I find it interesting that it combines people from so many different backgrounds with this common thread of machine learning and artificial intelligence. And it's the same thread that we find inside the artificial intelligence systems. They bring different groups together that wouldn't normally be found working together. That's powerful. Meetings like Beryl Elite here is exactly the right place. We've just spent 2 days talking among ourselves, people of different backgrounds, how to apply and de-risk the application of artificial intelligence. I was an astronaut in a former career, and there the machine and the human have to work perfectly together, seamlessly. It's very much like that. The artificial intelligent data scientist, computational scientist, needs to work with the conventional, say if you're in pharmaceuticals, medicinal chemist or computational chemist. They have to learn each other's business enough. And that's the challenge for a manager, is to bring the people that wouldn't normally work together to understand each other.
Beryl Conference is presenting such an outstanding lineup of speakers. I really enjoyed conversations about artificial intelligence and alternative data and all the emerging technologies in the industry. But what I found the most fascinating in this event is that it's bringing together the world of alternative investments and this new world of emerging technology. Hedge fund allocators are looking to invest with artificial intelligence-based strategies, and private equity investors and family offices are looking to invest in data vendors and data infrastructure providers.
Well, from this conference, we expect to give the message that Puerto Rico is such a unique place within the United States to do business. The lifestyle of Puerto Rico, the culture, everything that a person who will think of exploring opportunities or moving to Puerto Rico need to know. We are basically the lowest paying jurisdiction in terms of taxes in all the United States. We are US citizens, we are a territory of the United States, but the taxes that the US citizens pay on in Puerto Rico are basically from 0 to 4%.
But after going through this conference for last almost one and a half day, I think it is a lot starting from the how one can really curate the alternate data, which are typically pretty much, you know, in the raw form, then starting from there, how to do the feature engineering to really map it to the right level of relevance, whether it is quant or whether it is more of fundamental products, those type of stuff. See, I've also picked up this great terminologies just, you know, from this conference. So I see that it would be a lot useful to use AI to come out with the right type of product, especially for the products which are essentially a little bit short term. Because in that case, the AI can provide a great insight by consuming all the data, crunching them in an automated way, much more intelligent way, in a much lesser time frame.
You know, the conference was really interesting because we had a number of people who were talking about alternative data, a number of people talking about AI, a number of people who were talking about machine learning, and I think as I heard people talking, I realized just how the all three areas are really driving at one outcome, and the one outcome is really about making the investment process more profitable. Helping asset managers, for example, in really generating great ideas, and all of these three things working together, again, machine learning, AI, and alternative data, they really aren't independent of one another. They're really part of kind of the same ecosystem.
Because this is a wonderful experience for me coming from Argentina. Well, the Beryl Elites conference are a whole new world, a new experience for a way of saying it or putting it, because it combines enjoyment, it combines knowledge, and it combines innovation, and the speakers are highly inspirational. It's the world of finance in a cocktail with everything combined.
Well, I think the thing I found most interesting about the conference is the ability to introduce the idea of specific types of alt data to an audience that might not be familiar with it, but also to give more information to those that are familiar with it. So it's a great combination of, you know, newcomers and experienced folks around alternative data and what's going on in the markets in general. But I think that's also really important from that standpoint to understand what's your goal. So if you're looking for alpha generation, then you obviously have to look for data sets that are unique that will provide you the alpha you're looking for. But if you're looking for more of a risk mitigation or situational awareness standpoint, broadly used data sets could still be valuable because they're giving you insights that you may not have from other sources you're using. So it's really a thought of, you know, what are you really ultimately trying to achieve by bringing in alternative data and then finding the data set that provides that for you.
I think this conference is really good. I was here yesterday and today. The panel discussions are very in-depth. People know what they're talking about. I have made a few great connections. And it's very relevant. What's most important with this current economic condition, it's very relevant for the alternative investors to understand where the alternative data is going, where Bitcoin and alternative investment classes are coming up. So I think from a relevance perspective and from a depth perspective, I both find very impressive.
Yes, this is my first Beryl conference. It's been very informative and exciting. I particularly enjoyed some of the entertainment last night. I was very impressed with Vidak, who put together the event, with his musical talents. And honestly, I learned a lot of things that I wasn't expecting to learn about Puerto Rico, about blockchain, and in all honesty, alternative data is kind of my specialty, so not as much learning there, but definitely some good connections that I made. In terms of the hedge funds, it's really, you know, waiting. We're still kind of in a waiting game for them to be ready to really ingest a large amount of different types of data sets, because that's what we're really, where our specialty is in different types of data sets. Whereas on the vendor side, it's really being educated on what asset managers are looking for in those data sets.
Artificial intelligence, alternative data is very important. That's where the new alpha is coming, because lots of trades are being crowded on one side. So we're trying to find those niches, those alpha generations, those little tweaks. Everything is important these days, especially geopolitics. It's a little bit different than it used to be. Things are not happening the way they were happening before. So we're trying to, through data, we're trying to find and crystallize the process. Open mind is very important to be able to connect the dots between the world of arts and the world of finance. But it will be really interesting to bring alternative data, artificial intelligence, blockchain, and kind of merge it with the old world of hedge funds and private equity, and then have a nice show in the evening portraying the musicians who are actually mathematicians in their minds.